The marginal cost in dollars per MP3 player is given by C prime of x equals -0.25x plus 120. Determine the area under the function on the closed interval from 0 to 1000, and then interpret the results. So here we have the graph of our marginal cost function. And we want to determine the area under this function above the x-axis on the interval from 0 to 1000. So we want to determine the area of this shaded region. And notice how this region forms a trapezoid, so we can use this formula here to determine the area. You can think of this as a trapezoid turned on its side. Since this is a right angle, we'll call this side over here base 1, we'll call this short side here base 2. The height would be this horizontal length here. And because this function is continuous and non-negative on this interval, we can represent the area as a definite integral. The area would be equal to the integral on the interval from 0 to 1000 of our marginal cost function integrated with respect to x. But now we'll determine this area using our geometric formula. So we'll have 1/2 times base 1 plus base 2. Well, base 1 is 120 plus base 2 would be 20 times the height, which would be 1000. So we'd have 1/2 times 140 times 1000, which would be 70,000. So the area of this blue trapezoidal region is 70,000 square units. But to interpret the meaning of this, notice how we're multiplying the cost per MP3 player by the number of MP3 players. So this 70,000 actually represents the total cost of producing 1,000 MP3 players. Notice how the cost per MP3 player ranged from $120 each to $20 each, but the cost of producing all 1,000 MP3 players is $70,000. Next, we'll take a look at approximating area under a function when we don't have a geometric formula to determine the area. And then after approximating area under a function, we'll actually learn how we can use antiderivatives to determine area under functions from the fundamental theorem of calculus. I hope you found this example helpful.